Hi folks, this is another Stirling engine I made for experimenting with. I'll give a brief explanation of how it works, followed by some demos or experiments I did. And here's an animation of it in action. And here's a cutaway view. You can see the displacer moving up and down inside this cylinder, moving hot air from down here to up here to be cooled, before moving that air back down again. There's also a hole here between these two cylinders. When the air is heated, it expands and pushes out on this diaphragm. And likewise, when the air is cooled, it's compressed and the diaphragm is pulled inward. So the displacer just moves air around. The expansion caused by the heating and the compression provided by the cooling is what moves the diaphragm. And through this rod, moves the crankshaft and makes the whole thing work. The flywheel just stores energy for the times between the expansion and the compression to smooth out the movement. It took a little while to get heated up and running the first time. When it did, it wasn't very fast. Notice when I go in close that you can see smoke coming out of this support tube, probably a coating inside melting off. So I put some grease into the tube to block it a bit while still allowing the rod to move easily through it. And that made it move a little faster. But then I decided to pour some water over the top plate. That's to help with the cooling when the displacer moves the air in the cylinder to just under the top plate. As you can see, there was a big speed increase. I then decided to add grease everywhere else too, and everything seemed to run more smoothly, and maybe a bit faster. I'd also built in a homemade pressure release valve. That's in case the pressure was too high. I gradually opened it up and didn't see any difference, until it was open too much and the whole thing stopped. I next wanted to see if a lighter flywheel would help, so I removed the flywheel and weighed it. It was around 150 grams. I also weighed a single CD, and it was around 15 grams, one-tenth as much. So I hot glued a stack of 5 CDs to the bushing. That's half the weight of the wooden flywheel that I started out with. The difference was small, so it's hard to say, but I think there was an improvement. It was easy enough to remove 3 CDs and tape them out of the way on the wooden support without interfering with the shaft. That left just 2 CDs, but this time I didn't see any improvement. And lastly, the top plate was getting hot much too soon. That caused there to be no more cooling on top, and the whole thing would stop only after a minute or so. So I made this fan out of cardboard. It's not the ideal solution, but definitely a fun one. I designed it to blow air down onto the cooling plate. As you can see from the tissue paper, it does blow air. And it did take longer, at least a few minutes, before the top plate got too hot and the whole thing stopped. Anyway, that's some of the fun I've had with this Stirling engine. Well, thanks for watching. See my YouTube channel, rimstar.org, for more videos like this. That includes one about how a Stirling engine works, along with step-by-step construction for a simpler to make one. Another on how to make a Wimshurst machine, showing it step-by-step. And for variety, how a rocket works to get from Earth to space, using SpaceX's Falcon 9 as an example. And don't forget to subscribe if you like these videos, or give a thumbs up, or leave a question or comment below. See you soon!